Okay, so now let's go and see how to create, how to do point variations. Now once again, let me start with material master creation. Now you see here, when you go with MM01 creation of material master, you have seen, like, you know, the material number that you may see here in the material field can be generated internally, or it could be, you know, system may generate internally, or the user can give it externally. And also, like I said, industry sector and material type, these are the ones which separate the materials at highest level. So if you go into this drop down, you could see different types of, you know, the industries. You have got around 10-11 entries over here. How have they come here? They have been maintained in the configuration. Same is the case with material types. You may see here some 2013, all these things SAP has configured some of them, and people like you, me, whoever is working on the system, they have developed their own material types. Okay, so let me choose, for example, mechanical engineering material type as raw material. If I choose the raw material, look at here, and if I hit enter, you see here there are different views, or what we call it as tab pages appearing. Of course, some of them got selected. We will see how they got selected. But if you look at here, there are certain views which are in a some sequence. How is that sequence is coming? For example, when you are working for an implementation project, you need to create something called screen sequence. What does it mean, the screen sequence? The sequential order in which the screens to be appeared whenever you create a material master or a change or a display a material master. That is called screen sequence. Now we are going to work with screen sequence in today's class. Look at this. Let me go into a new session, SPRO, SAP Reference IMG. Okay, so here I'll go with something called material master configurations. Since material master is central master record for all the logistic modules, you have to go to logistics general, where you see something called material master. Okay, you see here material master. Go into this, and this is where the first five nodes, okay, first five nodes up to tools. These are important, or even not the fourth one that much important, but the first four nodes are very important for a person working in the MM implementation project, especially the guy who is setting up the material master. Always remember, if your material master configurations is not proper, all your business transactions in purchasing and in inventory management, they go and keep running. So therefore, while creating configurations or while setting up material master configurations, you have to do everything in a proper manner. Now let me go with configuring material master. So if you look at here, there is something called quick guide. This is a 24 page document. Okay, I read it many a times when I started my career. So I request you all to go through this document. Okay, it's a 24 document, very useful document. This will tell you everything about material master configuration. What is that required? What do you want to set up material masters? What is data screen? What is sub screen? Okay, so all those things. What is what we call it? Screen sequence. What is sequence number? What is screen number? All those things you will have it over here. So this guide description or information about how to set up material master, you please read yourself. I will actually go through the configuration. First one, define the structure of data screens for each of the screen sequence. You see here, when I went with MM01, whatever the screens that you see in the sequential order, like basic data 1, data 2, classification, sales, group ourselves, sorry, sales organization data, sales organization data 1, 2. This is a screen sequence. Okay, individual view. You see here basic data 1, basic data 2. This is called data screen. So now the point here we are discussing is structure of data screens for each screen sequence. I'm telling you this basic data 1, data basic data 2, classification, etc., etc. The order in which these views or screens are maintained is called one screen sequence. How to work with data screens in each of the screen sequence? What does it mean? It means you can have more than one screen sequence, and in each screen sequence you can have different, you know, sequence of order in which you can manage your screens. Alright, let me just go inside. Define structure of data screens for each screen sequence. Here you are going to see one standard screen sequence, and I am going to create one more screen sequence which is of my own, that is meant for Nissan group of companies. Okay, so let's go inside. You see here there are more than 20, means exactly 26 screen sequences are possible, are there. But in real time you may not have those many screen sequences. You may have 4, 5, something like that. All these Z relevant ones you will not be seeing it. Out of which I will take one screen sequence number 21. Let me just take you back once again to the configuration guide. Okay, you see here when you go with this, you see here not there here, just give me a moment, configuring. Yeah, you see here the standard material master for industry contains the following screens: 01, 11, 21, okay, 23, R1, so on and so forth. The number 21, it presents the screens as tab pages similar to the stack of index cards. Each tab page has a title, for example the name of user department such as purchasing or sales. It is the screen sequence present in the standard system. Okay, so this is the standard screen sequence. By default it will give you allows maximum of 21 lines to be displayed on each screen. It is intended for small screens. The one that we use, okay, I mean to say this one, the one that we use is the standard system is 21. So when you go inside the structure of data screens for each of the screen sequence, you have to look for the standard industry screen sequence in the short tab pages, which is 21. Why my system is very slow? What application sets are running? Okay, so now you see here this is standard industry short tab pages. So I'm going to copy this, like select 21, go with copy as. Here I wanted to change this to GN, standard industry tab pages for Nissan group. Okay, I would say tabs, say something like this. I would say enter. Okay, now you see here how the things are moving. The cursor is moving between, I'm not doing anything, the cursor is moving between screen sequence, data screen, subsequence, subscreens. You see how it is moving. So it means what? It is actually copying 21 screen sequence and creating ZN. By doing that, it is actually looking at various data screens, subscreens within the data screens, and trying to copy it. End of copying, you would see more than 5600 objects would have been copied. Okay, so let's wait for a couple more minutes and allow the system to complete the copying of 21 into our own screen sequence ZN. Alright, there was some error. Entry PL01001 does not exist in T001. It means some screen object has not been copied. So I wanted to remove that particular object and continue with the existing ones. Now you see here 6253 objects got copied into my ZN. Right? So you see here I have copied ZN. I'm going to save it under Nissan changes, right? So let it get saved. This is the heart of any ERP configuration, especially for the logistic module. As I said earlier, without MetalMaster, no logistic module will work properly. So therefore, MetalMaster setup is the major thing in logistic module setup. Now you see ZN got copied. Now you select ZN, go with data screens. This will tell you how many screens are there in my screen sequence ZN. You see here there are 67 screens. Are you going to see all of them? Do you require all of them for each of the material? $1 million question. You may not require all of them. For example, when you are creating raw material, what is the need of sales views? Raw material is meant for purchasing. You procure raw material and you sell the finished product. So why do we require sales views on the raw material? Similarly, why do we require purchasing views on the finished product? Are you getting my point? So that way, the business has to put questions on each of the things and then come up with which views are required for which material. That we will discuss it later moment. But these are the possible views one can have on ZN. You may ask me the question, like, you know, if I wanted to create my own screen and insert into this screen sequence, is it possible? 100% possible. Okay, but the new screen, you have to get it created by your developer. That also we will discuss it maybe towards the end of this class or maybe tomorrow. We may not be able to create any screen using Screen Painter, which is ABAP work, but I will tell you, if somebody has created a view with customer owns or customer specific fields, you can actually insert that screen in the screen sequence according to the requirements of the customer. Okay, now you see here my ZN. You need to understand this table before I delete some of the ones which I don't require. Let me explain you this entire table. The first column is called screen sequence, that is ZN. The second column is called screen numbers or the sequence numbers. You see 07, 08, 09, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, so on and so forth. If you look at it, you can see the difference. Not this one. Give me a moment. This one and this one. Okay, I will not be able to show you both together. You see here, my ZN, which is actually copied from 21, has got this sequence. Basic data 1 and 2, sales of data 1 and 2. Basic data 1 and 2, sales of data 1 and 2. Of course, the classification is there, which is not there here. Okay, so basically, this is called sequence of views. And whatever you see here, this is also called screen sequence, but this is not the place where you maintain the screen sequence. Okay, so these are called screen numbers, I would say. Next, this is the description of that screen. Then you see here there is something called I guess this is type of screen. Okay, let me check it. I assume it is type of screen or screen type. There are two types of screens possible, as you can see here. When I went with F1, main screen or also called a secondary screen. Let me open it here. Where is your Excel file? It's a PMM at the root 10. It's here. Okay. Okay, so here material master configurations. So here the first thing that you will be doing is configure material master. System is very slow today, so I'm gonna have to see my IT team today. Okay, so under this we are going to work with few things such as configure material master. Within this, the first thing that you are going to do is set up material master screen sequence. Okay, so in the material master screen sequence you will be working with something called data slash main screen. Okay, additional or okay, let me put it this way, additional or secondary screen. Okay, these are secondary screens. You'll be working with them, and also you will work with screen status. Okay, something called screen status. Screen type, and you have something called title type. Okay, so these are some of the things that you will be working with in the setup material master screen sequence. Right, so you see here, so this is title type. What is title type? Title type will tell you whether it is a main screen or a secondary screen. You see, whatever screens that you see here, when you go with Material Master, they are called main screens. I will simply show you a material which we have already created, slash and MM03 display Material Master. Oh, this is not our material. Okay, rear wheel tire, I guess, is our material. You see here, all these views are called basic. Does not exist in storage location 0001. I think it is in 0002. Right? You see here, these ones, this is called individual tab or tab page. Basic data 1, basic data 2, purchasing, etc. So the screens that you see here in this these are all called main or data screens. Then what is additional or secondary screen? Additional screens are nothing but when you go into additional data, these are called additional or secondary screens. So this will have its own type. additional screens are having screen type 2. You could see here, all ones means main screen. You could see one means main screen or data screen, two means secondary screen or additional screen. So by simply looking at this, you can say which is additional screen, which is main screen. You see here, descriptions, unit of measure, okay, basic data, consumption, costing details, etc. These are secondary screens. Whereas when you go into main data, you would see main screens, right? So this is about screen type. Next to screen type is the actual screen number. You see here, in which view we are in? Purchasing. You see, you are in the purchasing view. When you go into, for example, when you go into order unit, you take in, you put the cursor anywhere here, okay, anywhere here virtually, go with the F1, okay, you see technical information. Now you could see it here, screen number 2301, here you see one screen number, here also you will see a different screen number, okay. This screen number, the top one, 2301, look at here, purchasing, okay, what is the screen number? 4000. This is meant for purchasing, right? 4000 is meant for purchasing. You see here, screen field, because I selected purchase order unit or simply order unit, it is available in the 4000. We will get back to this 2301, what is it, in the next few minutes. So this will give you the exact screen number in which this particular, what is the number of the screen. Next, maintenance status. There is something called maintenance status, because if you look at your tabs, you see basic data 1 and 2 means basic data is coming twice. Purchasing text also would be there, okay, you see here 2 times. MRP 1, 2, 3, 4, so means there are 4 MRP views. So in order to, you know, minimize the complexity, SAP has given something called maintenance status for the various views. It means, which is nothing but grouping of various data screens according to their usage, according to the data retentions. Because basic data 1 and 2 is meant for maintaining basic data. So let me group these two fields together. MRP 1, 2, 3, 4 is meant for maintaining planning parameters for the materials at plant level. So let me group these four fields together and give only one status, right? So like this, you could see here, K stands for basic data, V stands for sales, sales organization data 1, sales organization data 2, sales general plan data, okay, sales text, all these things belongs to sales will have one status. Similarly, E, all purchasing related views will have one status, which is E. Similarly, all what you call PR, the production resource, production related thing will have one F. Plant related location, L. Quality management, Q. Similarly, B, accounting, business related. Similarly, D, MRP relevant. Okay, so like this you have different statuses. Okay, so the statuses is meant for that. Then there is something called GUI status, which the above us will use it. Time being, keep this aside. And then there is something called TT, that is title type. Title type means what? Look at here. When you go with the display material, this is what we call it as. What is this bar?
Material.
Sorry, Sundaragar, one part left. When you get ketchup.
Display material bar.
Are you want that dinni?
Menu bar.
Header bar. No sir, wrong. Anybody?
Title bar.
Exactly, title bar. So what is the title bar shall contain for a material master?
Yes.
Anybody looking at the title should be able to come to an understanding that I am in display transaction code of the material master. Okay, by simply looking at this display, what is the material number? This is your material number. What material does it belongs to, or what material type does it belongs to? Raw material. So your title of the application, which is nothing but here called as title bar, title of the application shall also contain some meaningful information. So there are various types of title bars are possible, in the sense the information displayed here, is it a two-part title or a three-part title or a single-part title? That information you can check it. You see here, when you go into additional data, you will have conversions, unit of measure conversion, units of measure. You see here, this information, when you have entered it, it would have come up in something like a pop-up screen where you have maintained one carton equals to 10 each. In the pop-up window, you would have maintained it. That pop-up is called as single part title. I'll just go and create it once again and then we'll show you. Okay. So title type is also important. This will tell you what does it contain. The title type, the title bar, what does it contain? Is it contains only transaction information or a material information, or transaction material and the material type information, or is it only material information? So like that you will have various options. Here you can have one part title, two part title, three part title, so on and so forth. You see here, one stands for two part title type for initial and main screens. Two means three part or four part title type for main screens. Three means single part title type, for example, for dialog boxes. Four means title type for configuration screens. Okay, so just to give you a feel of how does it looks like, two part title, how does it looks like, three part title, how does it looks like, I'm going to change this one. Look at here, two part title, I'm keeping it for basic data screens. Okay, or okay, you can either have first one or second one. Two part title for initial and main screens, three part title for main screens. So initial screen means what? Basic data screen 1 and 2. So what am I going to do? Let me, ideally I will be keeping only 2 or 1 for all the main screens, but just to give you only, you know, an idea of how it looks like. See here, I've given basic data 1 and 2, the title type 1, purchasing is title type 2, okay. I will go with, let me see, accounting, okay, that's also 2. Single part title, I will give it for the dialog boxes, say unit of measure. So which is available here somewhere in the unit of measure. You see here, units of measure, I wanted to give it a single part title, okay, which is 3. Okay, and also descriptions, in order to give you a feel of it. I'm sorry, 3, right? Then alternative screen description, right? So this is what the screen description is. Now I save it. I made a small change, I save it. Now you can ask me a question, why is this guy showing me all these screens? If I go with, for example, you see here, the first thing that I went into is screen sequence. I explained to you about the stable. Now I'm going to delete some of the screens. You see this each screen, wherever you see title type 1, this is called basic data screens. So here what you have to do is, based on your experience and expertise and also based on the requirements of the customer, you may have to keep all these views or you may delete the ones which is not required. For example, look at here. I am not dealing with quality management, because quality management is not going to be implemented for a specific customer, in this case Nissan. Then you don't require quality management view. Similarly, production resource tools, if you don't want to use it. Other way, whichever views which you do not require, you delete those views. Okay? Like work scheduling, I don't want it. I'm not going to deal warehouse management. Okay, so let me not use it. Or maybe you can keep it. Okay, costing views, descriptions, unit of measure, consumption, whatever views you wanted, you keep it. Whatever you do not want it, you delete them. Okay.
Can I ask a question now?
Yeah, please.
Sorry to stop you here. Now, the question is, why, just a tough question, you know, why we are using Zen, why can't we use 21? That is the first question.
You can very well use 21, sir, but 21 is a standard industry sequence. If you want to make any modification, like I told you, SAP recommends, do not make any modifications to the standard configurations given by SAP. You copy it, adopt the copy of the SAP standard configuration and then play with it. In case, let's say if you are making changes to 21, okay, you do not know exactly what you are going to do, or let's say you are doing trial and error basis on 21. If you lose that 21, where will you refer it? You will end up nowhere, and you may have to contact SAP once again for a simple thing. Therefore, best practice, or as per SAP recommendation, you copy 21, create your own, and then you play with it. Even if you make a mistake, you can once again copy 21, or you can look at, refer at 21, and then, you know, field by field, column by column, you can simply add it into your adopted object. That is the reason I'm copying myself and then working with my own screen sequence instead of working on 21.
Okay, great. Understood that. Thank you. The second question is, by having the ZN copied one, will that have whatever the materials I'm creating from now on, will it have the same screens which is copied from ZN? How do you link ZN to your materials?
Yes, I'm going to do that, sir. You have to wait until because this is not a simple thing. Like I said, this is the central thing, so I require two classes to complete Metal Master configuration.
Okay, so end of tomorrow's session,
session, you will be able to link it. How the screen sequence is linked with the Metal Masters that I am going to create from now onwards.
Okay. So whatever the ZN I've created will have, whichever on the config side of it, whatever the materials I'm going to create from later on, from tomorrow onwards, will have the screens copied from ZN. That's my assumption.
Exactly.
Okay, fine. Sorry asking you loads of questions.
No, not a problem. You can ask me. Because, you know, if you question me with your knowledge, you know, the other people will gain. So somebody has to raise the questions. That's the reason I keep asking you any questions. If somebody asks it, other people also will gain insight of the question or the answers into it. If nobody asks it, my job becomes easier. I'll get my money. But, you know, end of the day, what is important is not only me getting money, but you also should share my knowledge. So I always encourage questioning me. Sudhakar, I appreciate you. You are the only person asking questions, not the other people. So I recommend other people also, please raise your questions. Even I'm going in a flow, you stop me, ask me questions. So that's how you learn the subject.
Okay. The third one is, Venkata, is there, you know, you did mention to us that business will give you the requirements, what screens they want based on the application they have. Okay. Now, from a functional point of view, and based on your experience, you said consultant should try to propose to the client what sort of screens they should have. Do you have any standard, you know, screens, for example, for material management, you need to have by default these screens?
Yeah. Good question.
Rather than the business needs knowledge to us.
Yeah. So, based on the experience and expertise of the consultant, we do propose, in a, like I told you in the beginning, what is the purpose of having purchasing views on the sales material, okay? Or what is the purpose of having sales views on the raw material? You don't require it, but you may require the same thing, provided if it's a trading goods for you. It may be raw material, but of course, why can't it be trading goods? With one hand you buy it and with another hand you sell it, you can say. So that's the reason this answer to this question depends upon the customer's business scenarios. So when you look at customer, the first thing that you do is you visit the plant of the customer, see what exactly they were doing. Is it a manufacturing industry or is it a service oriented industry? If it's a manufacturing industry, what is that they produce? So based on that, you will have this question. Okay, so if you look at SAP manual, you can also will see what views by default you will get it on the different on a standard screen sequence. So when you go into, I mean, when you buy a fresh licensed server, you don't see these many screens and these many screen sequences. So SAP gives you the standard one, 21. So by look at it, I mean, in my 10 years experience, I might have worked with 3 customers on the Material Master, but we always follow SAP standard, and then wherever the customer needs it, we will simply change the sequence of the screen. For example, some customers may prefer purchasing view on top of accounting view. Some customers may prefer basic data 1 and 2 first and then purchasing view. Some customers prefer after basic data classification. So these are customer specific. So depending upon customer, we will add or delete some of the views.
Right, okay. Thanks, Rakesh. Another question.
Yeah, please.
Say for example, I have 5 screens in the ZN.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I have created hundreds of materials.
Right.
Now, tomorrow, my business comes and says that, okay, hang on, let's introduce work scheduling, okay, into your one of your screen, so that we have implemented plant and maintenance and asset-related services, okay?
Yeah.
Now, if I try to bring in the work schedule 31 into my ZN, mm-hmm. what impact will happen for my 100 materials, and what will happen? The impact on 101 material which I'm going to create tomorrow.
Okay. Again, the question is pretty straightforward and answer is also the similar way. Let's say you have 100 materials as on today with no work scheduling view. Correct? Now, for whatever business reasons, you want me to include work scheduling view in ZN. Right. I will assume it, I have deleted this one in the beginning. Now because you want it, I will find out the details of this particular line from 21 and then insert by going into new entries. Can you please give me a moment, please? sorry guys. Yeah, so assume you have removed the work scheduling, so all your handled materials as on date does not have work scheduling view. Now, because of customer requirement, you ask me to include work scheduling view, I add it. So from tomorrow onwards, when you raise a new material, when you create a new material, system will show you work scheduling view. You have to select it. And if you selected work scheduling view, you can... Can you just give me a moment, please? Pulavagar, morning, sir. Bhavan, sir, and I'm in class. I'm in the middle of the class right now. Shall I give you a call back by 12 o'clock? All right, thank you. I'm sorry. So, what happens is, all those materials which are existing as on date will have no work scheduling view maintained. Understand the word maintained. The view does not appear even though it is there. For example, you see here there are so many views. Unless you select a particular view while creating material master, the view will not get automatically selected. So, work scheduling view will be there for the previous materials from tomorrow onwards with no data maintained in the work scheduling view. But from tomorrow onwards, when you create a new material, if you select work scheduling view, only then it is available for data entry. Otherwise, it just remains there. It's like, you know, I may have 20 books related to SAP. Am I reading it? No, I'm not reading. So they are idle, simply lying in my, what you call, shelf. Only when I require, I take a book, I open it, I look into the book. Similarly, simply, you know, maintaining or keeping a view in the screen sequence doesn't mean that you are going to maintain that view. Only when you want to maintain some data into that view, you have to select it. So therefore, that's whether you have a view in today or whether you include a view, a particular tab, after down the line 6 months or 1 year, having no impact on the materials. If you maintain it, it is available. If you don't maintain it, it won't be available.
Great. Thanks, Venkat.
Yeah. All right. Any other questions? Right. So, you see here, I'm going to delete some of the views which I think may not be required for us. Let's say I don't want costing views. I'm not going to deal with controlling module in this class, so I don't require costing views. I don't require, let's say, warehouse management view too. Okay. Similarly, I don't require something called quality management. I don't require PRT, production resource tools. Okay. I don't require foreign trade also if I'm not doing anything. Similarly, foreign trade, export, let me delete this one also. See, I've selected some of the views and then going with delete. Out of 67 that you see here, these selected views will get deleted. So therefore, it will come to, okay, 1400 objects got deleted. Now you see 59, 67 to 59 has come. You keep it, right? Next. You may have a question. If I look at basic data 1, how does it looks like? If I look at basic data 1, how does it looks like? So, try to understand how I'm going, the sequence. First of all, I'm defining the screen sequence. Means what? My screen sequence ZN should contain what views? A, B, C, D are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 16, 60. Now, I am going with each screen that is basic data 1. You select it. Then you go into sub-screens. Just click it here. Within one basic screen, basic data screen, you see here, you have got 10 screens. Let me show you that. Main data. Now you see here, if I go into basic data 1 itself, you see here, material description, this itself is one screen. General data, this itself is one more screen. Material authorization group, I'm looking at the sections. This itself is one more screen. Packaging data, dimensions, one more screen. Right? Basic data text, another screen. So various subsections or sections within one basic data, one screen is considered as one page. How can I say? What is the background behind that? Look at here. When you look into basic data one screen and go into subscreens, look at here, there are 10 screens. Now here you have got two options: view data screen, view subscreen. Look at here, I did not select any of these ones, but I simply going with view data screen. Now you see, is it not main screen, that is basic data one? Look at here, material, description, review level. Material, description, of course here review level is not there. Then general data, you see here general data, under that there are some fields. And then material organization group is one. Look at here, dimensions, look at here, dimensions. Competitors, of course it's not there here, right? And then packaging material data, you see here packaging material data. So like that, what does it mean? Each of this view or each of this section is one full screen. Okay, I'll just go back. Now you see here, if I go and select a particular, this is subscreen, okay? Now you see here, if I go with this particular thing, select it, again, once again, if you go with view data screen, you see full screen. But if you go with view subscreen, whatever is there here, this itself is one screen. What is the number of the screen? 1002. Are you getting my point? View subscreen 01, this is the number 1002. Okay? Now you see, if you look at this one, 2001, this is screen number. How do I say? View subscreen, general data, right? Similarly, if you look at the third option, view subscreen, you see here authorization group, 2561, this is another screen. There is, let me introduce one more transaction code, which is nothing to do with functional consultant, but this is ABAP transaction code. Transaction code is SE51, which is meant for screen designing. Development.
Sorry, I was about to ask you that question.
Okay. Let me see. Overview.
Say suppose you enter the, if you change something on the screen, if you customize something.
Yeah.
What impact it will have?
I'll tell you. You see here, SE51, screen painter, using which you have to design it. Okay, Mandaka, we have some screen number. What is that? 2561. What is the program? SAP LMGD 1. SAP LMGD 1. SAP LMGD 1. Go with this one. Okay, using screen painter, ABAP develop screen. Look at your layout. So they use this tool called screen painter and create it. If you want to modify something within the standard screen also, it is possible. But again, you know, you have to take the permission from the architect. You see here, material authorization group, this is the field. Okay, so these are various what you call tools. Painter untun kadante word painter. It's like that. Okay, using which, for example, you wanted to draw this image, you can draw it. If you want to draw this image, you can draw it. Or if you want to go with this image, you can do so. So your screen painter is something like that. So label and the relevant field. So this is how, and this you see here, this is linked with Mara table. VEGRU is the field name. So if you want to write text, you can do so. There is lot of thing involved here. Okay, so this is how it looks like. SAPLM, this one. Okay, window coordinates, how it is located, at what place, at what space, all these things will be taken care by ABAPS. So you need not have to worry about it. Okay, let me close this one. So all these individual screens, they have been developed with this kind of functionality. In case if you want to add one more field within the existing subscreen, possible, but you yourself will not be able to do it. ABAPS should be doing. Or if you want to have one section, complete section, or rather subsection. For example, here I wanted to add one more section here. Customer defined fields, possible. You get one subscreen created and insert into the main screen, right? So that's how you do it. Okay.
Right. Should we need to do anything here on the config side of it?
No, except deleting the ones which you don't require.
Okay.
Look at here. For example, I do not want competitors. There is something called competitors. I saw it somewhere. You see here, competitors. I don't want this section. So I can delete it. Competitors. Which section is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th one. So subscreen, 5th screen is the one I think which is meant for competitors. For example, this one. Competitors. You see, you don't want this. When you don't want it, you select it and go with delete. That doesn't mean that it will go out of this table and you know you see 9 entries. No, that's not the way. It will remain be there, but it won't appear. Let me show you. Right? You see here. Save it. Now you select 5, you go with view subscreen. Now you see it's a different one. Okay? But you see the entries are still 10. Right? Similarly, if you look at the ones you see here, these are the ones which are already deleted. If you select the one, go with the view data subscreen, you see here. 2.01, it's not there. No more available. Right? So like this, you have to work with it. So after defining screen sequence, you have to keep only the screens, main screens which you wanted to retain. And also you work with subscreens, only the ones which you wanted to retain. Similarly, within the subscreen, within the main screen, you keep only the sections that you wanted to have. Once you are done with it, you save it. Okay? And then back here.
Then look.
Yeah.
To go back to that, you are like a screen.
You want me to go to the main screen, data, yes. This data one screen? Fine, I'll go with sir. Just give me a moment. Then select this, go with data screens.
Okay. Here we have a basic data one and basic data two. So certain fields from the basic data two, I would like to pull from there and have only one basic data rather than basic data one and two. So is it possible?
Okay. It is possible. But your screen becomes too large. Are you willing to have a too large a screen like this here, sir? You see here, even for this 5-6 sections only, I've got a scroll bar. Now what you are asking me was, I went into basic data 2, whatever sections I do, okay, I wanted, for example, other data. I wanted this particular piece to be available in my basic data 1. Is that your question, sir?
Yeah, say for example, you have basic data 1, competitor we remove.
Competitors, yes.
If you go to the basic data 2, just I want to pull the design drawing, that screen onto the basic data 1.
Correct.
So rest of them are, I don't want actually.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to remove that basic data 1 to just make it as a basic data.
Correct.
So that means basically changing the label and pulling that this field back into the particular basic data.
Yeah. So it is possible, Andy. Look at here. You go here, basic data 2, you go with subscreens, assume it is somewhere here. Design, okay, is this the one? Yes. You simply, what you have to do is take this entire thing. Okay, screen number, what is this basic data 2? 08 is meant for basic data 2. So what you have to do is, you have to first work with this way. SAPLM GD1 screen number 2003. So what you should do is go to basic data 2, which is this one, data 1, subscreens here, you go with new entries, select a row. For example, here. Okay, so you just have to enter a new line with screen 07, which is meant for basic data 1, and this is the sequence. For example, you wanted it towards the end or in the middle, depending upon that section, you have to add it here. This is your program, SAPLM GD1, and the screen number, whatever that one number is there, right, for that particular thing, you just have to add it here. And then you save it, it will come. Okay, can you just give me a moment, please? This will come up.
One question, sir.
Chapandi.
Suppose this is a Nissan Group rear tires description is there. Suppose in lubricant side, there are number of brands, equal brands. Suppose Bharat Petroleum one brand and Hindustan Petroleum one brand, Valtex like that. But suppose suppose Servo Prime 41 and 14 oil undi.
Sir, just give me a moment, Bharat sir.
Petroleum, Bharat Petroleum lo brand undi. Hindustan Petroleum brand
undi. Vastava? Maintain it kone? Matlab raha hai. సార్ అది క్లాస్ అండ్ వర్క్ కాల్ చేయనా టిఫిన్ చేసావా నీకు రాత్రి ఎంత సెట్ చెప్పినా కూడా నువ్వు పట్టించుకుంటాను సార్ నేను మళ్ళీ ఫోన్ చేస్తాను క్లాస్ అండ్ వర్క్ మాట్లాడతాను సార్ సుందరరావు గారు
ఓకే డిస్క్రిప్షన్ మీద డిఫరెంట్ బ్రాండ్స్ తో ఉంటాయి కంపెనీ బ్రాండ్స్ వేరు సబ్స్టిట్యూషన్స్ అటువంటి దానికి సెక్షన్ మనం అట్లాంటి దాంట్లో సెక్షన్ పెట్టుకోవడానికి ఏమన్నా అవకాశం ఉంది
లేదండి అప్పుడు మీరు ఏం చేయాలంటే మీ టైటిల్ టైప్ మీరే డిఫైన్ చేసుకోవాలి యు నో వాట్ ఈస్ ద టైటిల్ టైప్ మనం ఇక్కడ అనుకున్నాం కదా అరే బయట టైటిల్ టైప్ వన్ టూ త్రీ ఫోర్ ఉన్నాయి కదా, మీరు ఇంకొక టైటిల్ టైప్ మీరు పెట్టుకుని ఏ వ్యూ లో మీకు ఆ టైటిల్ టైప్ కావాలో ఆ వ్యూకి టైటిల్ టైప్ ని అసైన్ చేసుకోవాలి.
సపోజ్ ఇప్పుడు అంటే ఆ టైటిల్ లో మాడిఫై చేసుకోవడానికి అవకాశం ఉంది?
అది చేసుకోవడానికి ఉండదండి, అది కాన్ఫిగర్డ్ కదా, మీరు ఒకసారి పెట్టుకుంటే ఏం కావాలో అది టెంప్లేట్ అనమాట. టైటిల్ టైప్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ అ టెంప్లేట్. ఇప్పుడు ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ జెడ్ఎన్ ఉందనుకోండి, యూ గో ఇన్ టు దిస్ ప్లేస్ రైట్, సో ఇక్కడికి వెళ్ళండి మీరు. సో వాట్ హావ్ ఐ రిఫరింగ్ టు ఈస్ దిస్ వన్. ఈ టైటిల్ టైప్ వన్ టూ త్రీ ఫోర్ ఉన్నాయి కదండి, దీస్ ఆర్ టెంప్లేట్స్. ఇక్కడ మీరు మార్చుకోవడానికి ఏమి ఉండదు. టూ పార్ట్ టైటిల్ టైప్ అంటే ఇది, త్రీ పార్ట్ టైటిల్ టైప్ అంటే ఇది అని ఆటోమేటికలీ వస్తుంది. సో మీరు కావాలనుకుంటే యూ కెన్ హ్యావ్ యువర్ ఓన్ వే ఆఫ్ టైటిలింగ్ ది స్క్రీన్. అవి ఇక్కడ మీరు క్రియేట్ చేసుకోవాలి. హౌ, ఇది ఏ టేబుల్ లో ఉందో చూడాలి మీరు. జస్ట్ గో విత్ ఎఫ్ వన్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్. ఓకే, ఇక్కడ చూడండి, టైటిల్ టైప్ వన్ మీన్స్ టూ పార్ట్ టైటిల్ టైప్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మెయిన్ స్క్రీన్. దిస్ టైటిల్ ఈస్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ డిస్క్రిప్షన్. అంటే ఏంటి, MM01 తో వెళ్తే క్రియేట్ అని వస్తుంది, MM02 తో వెళ్తే చేంజ్ అని వస్తుంది, MM03 తో వెళ్తే డిస్ప్లే అని వస్తుంది రైట్. అది ఒక పార్ట్ అండి. రెండో టూ పార్ట్ టైటిల్ కదా ఇది. సెకండ్ పార్ట్ ఏంటి, ఆ మెటీరియల్ నేమ్ క్రియేట్ సో అండ్ సో అని వస్తుంది అనమాట. త్రీ పార్ట్ టైటిల్ అంటే ఏంటి చూడండి, క్రియేట్ వచ్చి జనరల్, తర్వాత మెటీరియల్ టైప్ వస్తుంది. ఓకే, అట్లా అనమాట. మీకు ఎట్లా కావాలంటే అట్లా మీరు డిజైన్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. సో నౌ యూ గో విత్ దిస్ టెక్నికల్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్. ఇక్కడ మీకు తెలుస్తుంది అనమాట ఎక్కడ దీన్ని డిఫైన్ చేశారు అని. యూ సీ హియర్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ టేబుల్ కాల్డ్ TITTY. ఈ టేబుల్ కి వెళ్తే యూ కెన్ డిఫైన్ యువర్ ఓన్ టైటిల్ టైప్. ఓకే, సో లెట్ మీ షో యూ /SM30. లెట్ మీ ఇంట్రొడ్యూస్ ఎ న్యూ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్. దేర్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ కాల్డ్ మెయింటైన్ టేబుల్ ఎంట్రీస్. This is my table. If I go with maintain, okay, this is not there in the dictionary, so I'll go with customize. Even this is also not there, so it's not allowing you to do it any ikkada. But ee table lo kelli meer data chudali ante even that's not available. So deeni meer cheyale. Oka vela nenu compulsory ga cheyali, I have to do it. This is my way of titling the pages or screens. If you want to say like that, you need to work with the basis administrator to open this table for you only for a specific period of time. అప్పుడు అతను మీకు సిస్టమ్ అంటే దొంగ చెట్టు ప్రాధాన్యం ఇవ్వడం అంటారు చూసారా. ఇట్స్ లైక్ దిస్, హీ విల్ గివ్ యూ SAP ఆల్ యాక్సెస్ టు యూ ఫర్ 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 20 minutes. At that particular point of time, when the keys are given to you, nobody else except you, nobody else will have access to this system. అప్పుడు మీకు కావాల్సినట్టుగా మీరు మార్చేసుకుని యూజ్ చేయొచ్చు. బట్ అనదర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఇన్ డూయింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ యూ మే, బికాస్ దిస్ ఈస్ అ కాన్ఫిగరబుల్ టైటిల్ టైప్, యూ కెన్ క్రియేట్ వన్, కానీ ఆ ప్రోగ్రామ్ లోంచి ట్రిగర్ అవుతుంది ఇది. సో వెన్ యూ ఆర్ క్రియేటింగ్ మెటీరియల్ మాస్టర్, లుక్ ఎట్ దిస్ సో అండ్ సో టేబుల్, టైటిల్ టైప్ ఏదైతే అది పికప్ చేసుకోమని. ఒకవేళ అదే హార్డ్ కోడెడ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ అనుకోండి, యూ నీడ్ టు వర్క్ విత్ అ ప్రోగ్రామర్, ప్రోగ్రామ్ చేంజ్ చేయాలి, అప్పుడు కాన్ఫిగరేషన్స్ పని చేయవు. రైట్, ఓకే. సో నౌ వాట్ హావ్ ఐ డన్, ఐ హావ్ క్రియేటెడ్ మై స్క్రీన్ సీక్వెన్స్. ఇంకా నేను ఈ స్క్రీన్ సీక్వెన్స్ ని అసైన్ చేయలేదండి, ఐ హావ్ సింప్లీ క్రియేటెడ్ ఎ స్క్రీన్ సీక్వెన్స్. నౌ the next thing I am going to do is assign secondary screens. Next point, assign secondary screens. What do you mean by secondary screens? Like I told you, when you go into additional data, whatever screens that you see here, these are called additional data screens or secondary screens. Ivanni kuda, so you will be working with them. You just go and click it here. Okay, what's your screen sequence? ZN, right? So you maintain ZN here. You see here, go with this, go with details. Now you see here, these are allowed eligible secondary screens. You just go and delete the ones which you don't require. For example, giant production on the I'll just go and simply delete it. When I go with delete it, when I go with delete it, this function code will be vanished from here. And then the function code and enter this and make this is again from the above. When you click on this, button kirinda unde action ni function code enter. When I click with right left mouse click on descriptions, then kirinda ok action rastar above us. That action is called function code. అంటే ఏంటి ఈ బటన్ ప్రెస్ చేసినా కూడా ఏమి రాదు ఇంకా మీకు రానక్కర్లేదు అనుకున్నప్పుడు యూ జస్ట్ గో అండ్ డిలీట్ ఇట్ రైట్ సో లైక్ దిస్ వాట్ ఎవర్ స్క్రీన్స్ యూ డోంట్ వాంట్ ఇట్ యు కెన్ సీ హియర్ ఇవన్నీ డిలీట్ చేస్తారండి సంబడి వుడ్ హావ్ డిలీటెడ్ ఆర్ రాదర్ 21 లో ఏవైతే సెకండరీ స్క్రీన్స్ ఉన్నాయో ఆ సెకండరీ స్క్రీన్స్ కి ఇక్కడ ఏమి లేవు ఫంక్షన్ కోడ్స్ లేవు ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు యూజ్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ టెక్స్ట్ యూ హావ్ టు గెట్ ఇట్ డన్ దీనికి ఏముందో ఇక్కడ చూసుకోవాలన్నమాట రైట్ సో లుక్ ఫర్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ టెక్స్ట్ ఇక్కడ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ టెక్స్ట్ ఉందా యూ జస్ట్ గో అండ్ చెక్ ఇట్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ ఓకే సో మేబీ PB01 ఏమో ఐ డోంట్ నో సో యూ జస్ట్ హావ్ టు యాడ్ ఇట్ హియర్ యాక్చువల్ గా దీని క్రింద కోడ్ ఉంటుంది దిస్ ఈస్ వాట్ వి కాల్ ఇట్ యాస్ కోడింగ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ దీంట్లో PB01 ఆర్ PB02 వాట్ ఎవర్ దిస్ విల్ కంటైన్ ద టెక్స్ట్ హలో యా ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ ద మిడిల్ ఆఫ్ ద మీటింగ్ కెన్ యూ ప్లీజ్ గివ్ మీ కాల్ ఆఫ్టర్ 30 మినిట్స్ థ్యాంక్ యూ Alright, so even in case if you have deleted wrongly, you just have to look at the right function code and add it here so that it gets enabled. Okay, so this is how we work with the secondary screens. The ones which you don't want it, just delete it. If you do it in, wrongly, mistakenly, ensure that the proper function code is available here and then you take it. Okay. So you can make description choose code and you can just go and have a look at it. Okay. So probably this one. It may be pet calls or not. Right? So then you save it. Okay. So invalid push button function code. You see here this is not a valid one.
If I go with code is different.
Yeah. If I go with
code or
no, even this one is not right one. Okay, it's not taking any. Okay, so apprehension maybe you should go with create. Okay, you see here, this is something like this. You should go with create and then you save it. Okay, now I have got main screens, I have got additional screens. Are you getting my point? Main screen, first of all screen sequence, then data screens are main screens, and then secondary screens are additional screens. Okay, so let me write it here so that you won't forget it. So here what am I doing? Set up middlemost screen sequence. Then you work with main screens. Then you work with additional screens. Okay, and then you are working with screen sequence. The third point is you will be working with the screen sequence. How do we work with screen sequence? Now you see here. Maintain the order of main and additional screens. You have to click it here. Right? What is your screen sequence? ZN. Take the ZN. Go with the details. Here you will be working with your own screen sequence. Now you see here. This is the interval between two screens is 10. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. The one with the lowest number is the one with the one which appears first. So, for example, screen sequence, I wanted it this way. Basic data, purchasing, okay, classification, and then MRP, forecasting, because forecasting is part of MRP, right? And then let's say I want general plan, data, storage views, and then for example accounting. Assuming these are the views that I want, I mean these are the sequence in which I would like to have my screen sequence. So you have to work with this. What did I say? Basic data view is the one which I wanted first for my specific customer. So basic data 1 and 2 first screens. It is there right now. Good. What is the second view I wanted? Purchasing. So you look for purchasing. It is 80. Now if I change this to 21 and purchase order text will also be there. You see here, I change this to 22. Now you see sort of main and secondary main screens. Now you see, have the comment sit here, 21 becomes 30, 22 becomes 40. After that classification I wanted. This is what I said, right? Classification. And then MRP views. In MRP I have got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So look for MRP. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? See here 100, 110, 120, 130, 140. So what I wanted, all these views I wanted after my classification. So 50 is the classification. So what I do is 51, right? 52, 53, come on. Okay, 53, 54, and forecasting, which is part of MRP, I will make it as 55. Now this 51 becomes how much? 60, isn't it? Classification is 50. After 50, it is 51 because it is the intervals are of 10. So 51 becomes 60. Look at here. Right? Next. After that, what do you want? After MRP forecasting, I want general plan data storage one view, which is maintained over here. General plan data storage view. So my forecasting is 100. After this, I want general plan data. So I should go with 101, 102. Right? Once again, sort main and main screens. So after general plan data, what else I want is accounting view. Accounting view is 181 right now. I wanted this after 120. So I make it as 121. Give me a moment. Accounting 2. Okay, 122. Okay, say sort main and additional screens. Right, now you see there is, okay, in inventory management you may require few more screens like plant, stock, storage, location, stock. I wanted these two to be available next to my accounting views. Right, so I will make this as 141. Is it 140? Yeah, 141, this is 142, right? Next, for the special procurement scenario, there is something called third party sales order processing where I wanted to maintain sales views for the material master. So I wanted these things, after storage location start, sales or data, okay, this is okay. This is how I wanted. Then I wanted warehouse management view, after that, okay, WM execution, QM packaging. Okay, this is how I wanted the order. Similarly, if you want to, you know, work with it, description, unit of measure, after that basic data text, let's say I wanted this to be immediately available next to UOM. Make it as 21. Right? then inspection text, internal comment, consumption. Okay, let me put consumption is next to my basic data text, let's say 31. Can you just give me a moment, please? Hello? Yeah? I'm sorry, your voice is not clear. Can you please speak a little louder? Somebody did contacted me just now from the same consultancy. I'm in a meeting, so I've asked her to give me a call after 12:10 or so. Thank you. Alright, so once you maintain the screen sequence, that is order of sequence in which your screens to appear, you save it. Okay, with this, are you going to see the screen sequence? Not yet. Right? Next, once you maintain the screen sequence, there is one more thing, the most important thing, that is this one. Assign screen sequence to user material type and transaction and industry sector. So here I would say assign screen sequence to, there are four parameters which controls screen sequence. What are they? Transaction code, material type, okay, industry sector and user. These are the four parameters. This is an interview question and certification question as well. In interview, people will ask you, if you say that you have set up the material master, they'll ask you on what basis the screen sequence appears. Okay, what are the parameters which controls the screen sequence? Four parameters. One, transaction code. Two, material type. Three, industry sector. And four, the user ID. Okay, now you see here. Let me go into this one. Right? So here, if you look at the first one, screen reference transaction, okay, 01. Screen reference user. Wherever you see star, it means for all the users. Screen reference material type, it means for all the material types. Screen reference industry sector, it means for all industry sectors. What is the current screen sequence available? 21. Now I wanted my screen sequence to appear here, which is CN. Where is that? This one. Okay, with this, your material master configuration is complete. So you can have various permutations and combinations. In real time, don't worry, you will not have this many entries. At max, 2 or 3 or only 1. If you want to follow the screen sequence, a standard screen sequence, irrespective of the material types or industry sectors, or transaction codes, we use this one. Or if you want to maintain certain permutations and combinations, you go with another 2 or 3, but not all of them. Okay, so with this, if you maintain this, it means, what does it mean? For all users, for all material types, for all industry sectors, you see the first one, screen reference transaction 01, which is by default it is 01 only, means for all transaction codes, industry screen sequence, what I wanted is ZN. Say, save it. Now, you go and create a material master. / NMM01. Okay? Enter. Do you see the views that I have configured? Or do you see the sequence of views that I have configured? Yes or no?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay, right now you see there are no view got selected by default. Up to now, previously, there are certain views, you know, like that you would have seen some views got selected. That's a different story that we will work in tomorrow. So, I have done first part, that is screen sequence, data screens, additional screens, and the assignment of screen sequence to a material type transaction code user and industry sector. Is this clear to everybody? Sudhakar, Sridhar.
Yeah. Fine. Thank you.
Okay. So once you are done with it, let me go and complete this node. Define. Okay. These are only meant for your information purpose only. The first four lines are important, not the ones that I'm going to show you in the next couple of minutes. Define how maintenance statuses are determined in data transfer. You just have to ensure that as far as possible, single status field should be used for your screen sequence. So if you go into ZN, you see here, this is something called maintenance status. As much as possible, single status should be used. Okay, means this one. Means what? We will see what is the status, okay? In the next class, when we discuss with field selection properties, we will discuss about field statuses of the fields. So as much as possible, single status is required. So if you want to see what is the status, just go with the F1 and here you will see the information. In data transfer, this key defines how the maintenance status of a material are determined on the basis of the fields transferred. Why data transfer? Majority of the time you take the data from the old system and dump it into your new SAP system into the relevant fields. At that point of time, it's good to have only one field status, not to have multiple field statuses. Okay, so therefore this you have to ensure that only one status will be there. By default it is one single status, so you need not have to worry about it. And then create program for customized subscreens. Sridhar, to answer your question sometime back, you asked me a particular section of basic data 2 view. I wanted it to be maintained in the basic data 1. It could be that one, or it could be creation of a new screen altogether and then inserting into the existing views. Everything can be done using this node called create program for customized subscreens. Again, this is not meant for you. ABAPR will be doing it for you only. Okay, because creation of a program is not your job. ABAPR will create a program for a specific custom screen, and that program, that screen, he needs to link it. Once he has done it, he will use it. You see here, a screen needs to be linked with a function group. This is ABAPR's job, so they will do it. Once it is given to you, you can work with it. Maintain user settings, this is nothing but the basis transaction, so even this also you can skip it. User related settings, everything will be done by the basis team, so therefore you need not have to worry about the last two. The third last one is basically the a screen or what you call field status, which is used in data transfer, which is by default maintained, so you need not have to worry about the last three sections. Otherwise, the first four are mandatory. Okay, the next thing. Okay, so these are the various things that we, you know, go with this maintain user related things. Right, the next one is, once we complete this, you have to work with this field selection. Okay, so in the field selection, okay, we will, shall we see tomorrow, because it's going to take about half an hour. All right, let me work with rest of the notes tomorrow. I think it's almost 11:55. I guess for Sridhar it's getting delayed, and even for me also, I'll have to, you know, go to my office. So we will cover rest of the MetaMask configuration like field selection, basic settings, and settings for key fields. If not settings for key fields, these two will be completed tomorrow. And then in about two classes, we will complete the entire MetaMask configurations. Any questions from anybody?
Nothing, Vangar. Thanks.
Lakshmi, Pavitra, and Radhika?
Nothing, sir. Thank you.
All right, then. I'm stopping the session for today. We will meet tomorrow, same time, 10 o'clock. And once again, I'm sorry. My system has given me some trouble in logging into it. Logging into GoToMeeting in the beginning, so that's why we got delayed, but otherwise I would have completed quick selections also. Alright, see you.